Don't, please don't do that. Stop it. Don't do that.
Welcome to the Buck Bayou. Here on Grown Man Record Night. We got both these mics up. Everybody's mic.
My mic up?
Is Steve's mic up?
I'm glad.
Steve's joining us here on Grown Man Record Night. Welcome back to the program, Steve.
Hola.
Hello.
Hola.
That means hola in Spanish for hello people.
That's because I ate a witch tonight. So.
Witch. Tell me about witch. What's that all about?
It's like you go in and kind of write up your order and hand it to them and they make it to order.
That sounds like a lazy restaurant to me.
Sandwiches, but it's like more like a sub sandwich.
You like sandwiches? You ever had a panini?
I'm a sandwich fan. Sandwich is a good thing. Casseroles and sandwiches, you kind of cover a lot of ground with a casserole or a sandwich.
Cowboy boots.
Cowboy boots are awesome, but you got to have a hat to go with it.
Yeah.
And as you can tell, I didn't wear a hat.
No, you didn't wear a hat.
I do like hats.
You know what we do for that?
I have a lot of hats.
We do a salute for Steve, and we say, no hat. Steve's got no hat. That's all right. We're still keeping it live and real here on Grown Man Record Night. We appreciate everybody joining us. Hope everybody's having a good time. It's Friday evening. We're sure enjoying ourselves here. We got a big studio audience. Lots of people in the crib hanging out this evening. We're enjoying some fine cigars.
I'm really enjoying the cigar.
Yeah. We're doing some nice things here. We got our good friend Jeff is also in the house here. Now, Jeff, tell us a little bit about these cigars that we're smoking here. What's this all about? This seems like a big deal. This tastes nice.
Mike, that's a La Aurora.
My picture.
Yours is a Corojo. I have the Connecticut. These are very nice cigars. They came in those fancy tubes sitting in front of you there.
Look at that gold, man. Gold tube, man.
That's an awesome tube.
It's all backwards.
Yeah, that's good times. These are high dollar deals, though, right?
La Aurora.
They were nothing for me, so.
It's
free for me. It's good for me.
Smoke a cigar every now and then. It's good.
Sapphire.
Good flavor,
golden
man.
Golden sapphire. So you got the sapphire.
Yeah.
Or you got the gold. You got the sapphire.
I got the gold, right?
What's the difference? I guess you can't tell unless you guys.
You can't tell
unless you guys kissed.
No. This wrapper seemed just a shade darker, perhaps. Perhaps.
Perhaps.
Perhaps. Perhaps. Perhaps.
Very nice. Very smooth.
Yeah. So what's been going on in the record world? You've been getting into the stores. What have you been doing?
I took a week. I was gone to Atlanta to see family. And I did a little digging in Atlanta.
Right.
Before that, I think I did a little digging in Greensboro.
Yeah.
At CFBG.
Yeah, nice.
Great record store. And I've come to find that it's a great record store because it doesn't really try to overprice good records. It wants to move them. The store in Atlanta that I got some records at, the average price is $12.
Yeah, that's like start,
You look at most records, 12, you know you got a problem. Because then you're going to run into 18 and 24, and that's some places that's normal.
And a lot of them are worth that.
But you kind of want to buy a few records. You don't want to go out with one record. I did spend more money than I've ever spent.
It's just a different kind of shop.
I felt bad about it.
It'd be cool if you lived in Atlanta because there's probably their own little dig spots and stuff as well. And then when you need, damn, I want that one record. I've been saving up for it. I'm going to go get it.
Yep.
You want that one copy of the Beatles record that you don't have. You're going to go
get it. But I will say, and I'll show you in a minute, I just can't resist showing to you now. We're going to hold it off.
We're going to hold it off.
But there was one record I came across. It's one of those things that, for me, when you find something like this.
As a man. As a Steve man.
Almost knocks you to your knees and you feel like, this is something I have to kind of complete a little empty part of my life right
there.
It's right there. But
okay,
yeah.
That's so awesome.
Yeah.
Hey, we want to remind everybody that, if you miss a Grown Man Record Night live on Ustream, which you can catch every Friday night from 8:30 till, I don't know, sometimes really late at night, we play a lot of really cool music. We also do this program, and we've ended up putting this program on the YouTube channel. And so if you ever miss a segment and you enjoy the Grown Man Record Night program, you're going to want to go to the YouTube. And it's youtube.com.
What's that, YouTube?
The URL, the Universal Resource Locator.
You go to the YouTube.
Yeah. This is going to be a pretty big deal. You guys may want to get YouTube to come down here and cover this.
Would that be Google?
No, you're not. You got to.
Google owns YouTube.
Yeah, absolutely. So you can log in with your Google account. But like us and stuff. YouTube.com/MacheteMiller. And all the segments will end up there eventually. And we're about a week and a half behind on our segments.
One thing I'll remind everybody is AdBlocker Plus.
Oh, sure,
also
man.
Get that because it'll work on YouTube. It works in Ustream. It works just about any program.
If you run Firefox or Chrome, I know for a fact.
The show doesn't get taken. You don't leave the show and watch it.
There's none of those ads during Ustream, and it gets rid of the ads on YouTube. And for that matter, even on Facebook, you know, the stream of ads down the right side of the page, they're gone. They're all gone.
Some local news websites.
News websites, you get rid of the ads.
But we want those commercials, please.
Those are irritating.
Those are great commercials.
You know, I think mentioned something of.
I love commercials.
A friend of mine who's in the news business,
yes.
Down in a different market, he's leaving the TV news business and going into doing wrestling videos and working for the Carolina Panthers, and he left a comment on there that some of the stuff we do between the irritating car commercials, all the bullshit we do between the irritating car commercials doesn't matter, but it's the people involved. All right.
Okay.
He's an interesting gentleman.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, he's an interesting gentleman.
Oh yeah.
He's a good
good
boy.
Good boy.
Trained him well.
Absolutely.
So you want to talk about some records?
We can talk about some records.
Or is there something you want to talk about before?
I don't think there's anything I want to talk about.
No agenda, no itinerary, no new releases tonight?
No, I'm not going to talk about anything going on right now. We got a sad note we're going to mention in Dig of the Week, and so I don't know. I don't really want
to. I will say it's back to school.
Sure.
And some places are having sales. I think CFBG tomorrow is having a sale. They're discounting items as well as having their dollar records or four for a dollar.
Four for a dollar, man. So, I'm really thinking about that.
It's pretty good.
That's a good deal.
You can go and spend $5 and walk away with 20 records. You're pretty happy.
Yeah, we need more records, right? Isn't that right?
Yeah. I see you got a new shelf.
We got a new shelf.
It looks good.
We got a new shelf going over here. And
perfect. It fits perfect.
And the living room's full of records, and we got a lot of records over here. That's what we do. I mean, it's Grown Man Record Night. You have a good time on Friday night. You need records, and we're running out of room to put our records.
And Fridays keep coming.
Fridays keep coming, records keep coming, and I mean, we're stacking them up, man. Lengthwise, oblong, and edge whizzle. We're
stacking them deep.
Pricing them right, stacking them deep.
Yeah, free. Just take them.
Cameraman's trying to get rid of some records. Cameron, what you been doing? You been getting in the stores?
Yeah, no.
You been going? You need to go back to Goodwill, man. You hadn't been hitting anything since you got all those records. I think you're a little gun-shy about it. I think you need to get back in the store, man, rekindle that flavor.
You can take a hit like that, you're like, oh my God.
Yeah, but he needs to rekindle that fire to get back in to start digging, man.
Kindle fire.
You need to rekindle that fire to get going. Don't forget what it's about, man, to getting in the stores and picking up something crazy that you never knew about, and then you put it on and like, oh, that's a really cool record. And you hadn't done that in a while because you got all those records in there. Get back on it, man. Number one priority. That's the number one priority.
See any good movies lately?
I hate everything. What are we watching over here? Steve brought Koi Anastotsky, which we're playing over here, which is like a film school staple for any of our film buffs.
You studied it, right?
I studied the film. I studied the film pretty hard, and I watched it when I got out of film school because it's a really cool film. Cinepoem, we call it.
Cinepoem.
A cinepoem or a
poem?
Soundscape.
Poem? Cinepoem?
Yeah, cinepoem.
Paul.
Paul. That's my middle name. Paul.
Paul.
Sort of poet.
Yeah. Okay, so let's get into... I'll lump this in. Let's go ahead and go to a Dig of the Week. We're going to talk about a Dig of the Week, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to lump in some of the stuff we played this evening, as well as some of the cool stuff that Steve has brought this evening, and a special little treat we're going to talk about. We've been still mixing it up here on the program, and we started off with a record we played last week just to get everything calibrated right and get things moving. And then we started off just mixing it up, man, just keeping it moving. Different things here, there, yonder, to, fro, hither, etc., so forth and so on. And started that out with a Chicago Transit Authority, man. You missed that.
I did miss that.
This is not the greatest copy, man. It's a little scratchy, but it was like $2.
You know what's funny about that?
Yeah.
I thought I had it.
Right.
I don't have it.
You don't have it at
all.
I
kept talking to you about, you need to get this.
We've passed several copies over.
I would show it and say, look, you should get this. I have it. It's awesome.
Right.
I don't have it. I thought I did.
I got it.
It's great.
Cameraman got it in the box, I believe. Especially, his copy
it gets
better.
Weird with that purple.
No, it's just one of the records.
Where Terry Kath plays guitar.
Yeah.
And it's just like.
Oh, there's sides where it was like, is this freaking Hendrix, man? It sounds like Hendrix, and then you hear like a horn, and you're like, what is going on?
Hendrix was a fan. He was a big fan of Terry Kath.
That, man, that's great stuff. So we jammed some of that stuff earlier. What kind of led the program off of that? Oh, Lord. I'm knocking stuff over. We got Castle Grayskull down here. I just knocked some people over. Followed it up with a little Eddie Lockjaw Davis, Sweet and Lovely. Man, I love this record. This is recorded July 26, 75 in Nice. Oh, man. This is just great. It's on the CJ level. It's Classic Jazz 116. Great. Look at this. Let's show this off a little bit. Hold that guy up there. There we go. That's a great staple. I got a couple of Eddie Lockjaw Davis. And, you know, I picked up on names like that when I was a kid watching The Cosby Show. Because when I really started, Bill Cosby would talk on The Cosby Show about how he had, like, one little record player. And he would go downstairs and just have his little crate of jazz records and his little record player with a speaker. A bit, a little bit, 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 a bit, a little bit. And that's what he would say about it. And, he would use, like, Clean Head and Lockjaw and names like that. So I knew when I started digging on jazz, because I've loved jazz since I was a little bitty kid. And weird for a little country fella, because nobody in my family or around me liked jazz. But I heard it, and I was just like, oh,
something about it.
Little kid, man, just like, whoa. And, but I learned from Bill Cosby. He named things like that, so I knew if you had a guy's name, and he had a nickname, like in parentheses, like that, a parenthetical nickname, we'll call it here for the program. I knew to pick it up. And it's always, that's another one of my good, if it's got a good nickname.
Gate Mouth.
Exactly.
That's not a good.
Lightning, Gate Mouth, Lockjaw, Clean Head. Oh, man. And another one, you know, I've said before, if it's black and white and got a picture of like some jazz dude smoking cigarettes, like sitting around recording, I'm going to buy it, man. Hey, we followed that up with one of my new favorite reggae artists. Alpha Blondie. We played this a little bit here on the program. I picked this up here recently. And this is a French cat that's really in reggae. And this is the original pressing was Dutch in like 82, I think. This is an 84 re-release. Really cool reggae, man. Look at that cover, man. It's awesome. Really cool reggae, man. And I don't have enough in my collection. And I know now if I run across Alpha Blondie, this is the Kokodi Rock album.
Yeah, that's cool.
I know if I run across that to pick it up. It's great reggae. Followed that right after that with a little Brand X. Oh, you know, we love some Brand X.
Is Phil Collins on that one?
Let's see here. I don't know. I think he plays on like one of the tracks or a couple of the tracks. Some of the tracks. He's not on everyone, I don't
think.
That's good. This is 1980 on Passport Records. This is Brand X, Do They Hurt. Classic, man. Great fusion, funk. Oh, man. So proggy.
It's Prog Fusion, yeah.
Oh, Prog Fusion. It's there, man.
Prog Fusion.
That's the kind of stuff we really dig here on Grown Man Record Night. We got a common thread here, and that's right up the gut, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Right up the gut.
You played all these?
Yeah, we played all these earlier.
Ooh,
yeah,
I missed out a whole lot.
Yeah, when
I was kind of getting rained on. It was like heavy, heavy rain.
Yeah.
I just didn't want to get in the car. I didn't want to make the trip to the car with the records, you know.
Sure.
I had them in a trash bag. The trash bag had that odor blocker. It was, so now my records
smell fresh.
Smell like chemical.
Well, it did, yeah, I like that. I like that record sitting in crate smell. You know, like that library smell.
When I was, you were playing the Doobies when I was here.
Right, Jeff picked this out. Jeff's a big Doobies fan.
Yep.
So we rocked this. One of my many Doobies records. This is the best of.
Can't go wrong with that.
No, it's got the classic hits on it. We played side two. This is 76 on Warner. Started the side two is the hell is it? Jesus Is Just All Right, Keeps You Running, South City, Midnight Lady, Take Me in Your Arms Without You.
You kind of wonder when you see this guy right here, you wonder, did he ever eat?
'70s rock.
Show that picture, man.
Look at skinny guy on the far side.
So skinny.
'70s rock stars, man.
He's got the 70s rock look, though.
You know, I played a lot of shows live for a long, long, long time. And you know what we always ended up doing is drinking a bunch of beer, going and eating a bunch of crappy food, going to a lot of buffets and stuff. If anything, we got fat. All these 70s rock stars.
They didn't have buffets.
What the hell, man? They were also skinny. And I don't,
drugs.
They're not all on heroin, for crying out loud. I mean, gee whiz. How did they pull that off?
That's crazy.
That's crazy, man. That's crazy talk. So right after the Doobies, went into a little Mike Cross, Live and Kicking. Special record to me. This is 1981 on Sugar Hill Records, which is a legendary bluegrass label. Is that correct, cameraman? Absolutely.
Sugar Hill.
Didn't Doc Watson record on there? Somebody.
Lots of people.
Lots of people recorded on there. And it's out of Durham.
It's not the same Sugar Hill did all Rapper's Delight.
No.
But this is Sugar Hill Gain.
Well, that was Sugar Hill, though.
They're out of Durham, North Carolina.
The label was called Sugar Hill Gain. The label was Sugar Hill.
And this was recorded live at the Thalian Hall in Wilmington, North Carolina. Cameraman lived there for a very long time. That's a historic place.
What year is that?
81.
Because my wife, no, that would have been later.
She saw him in.
She saw Mike Cross at NC State.
Right.
Oldest theater association in North Carolina.
Oldest theater association in North Carolina. Nice.
Have you checked their license on that?
I don't know. Let's run the research. We played side two, which leads off with Whiskey for Breakfast, which is a song I lived for a little bit, and a song that I'm very fond of. And that whole side was very good. Nice little change from what we normally run here on Grown Men Record Night. We play that a little bit.
Yeah.
We do play that a little bit. And you know, I want to talk about one more record, man. And it's a shame that we have to talk about this record in this particular way, because old Cedar Walton, pianist and composer, died at 79 this past week. And one of our favorite records, and probably one of my favorite records, at least that Cameraman has in his collection, is this Breakthrough on a Cobblestone label.
I love the cover.
But it's got a... I would say cobblestone, but it is cobblestone.
Did you say gobblestone?
Yeah, but look at that. Look at that. That looks like a G. I thought they were being cute about it.
Wow.
Yeah. But this is Cedar Walton and Hank Mobley Quintet. And who else is on that, Steve?
We got Charles Davis on sax, Sam Jones bass, Billy Higgins on drums.
Solid. That is solid. And this record really jams.
Hank Mobley's awesome.
I hate it that, Hank Mobley kills it. And I hate Cedar Walton passed away, man. Let's hold this up. Let's hold that up for a second. I'll just read a little bit about Cedar Walton. Pianist who distinguished himself as both accompanist and a soloist, who wrote most of the enduring compositions in modern jazz while a member of Art Blakey's Jazz Messengers.
Art Blakey.
Oh, man, that's solid. The early 60s, he died on Monday. He's home in Brooklyn. He was 79. He sat in with Charlie Parker. Man, spent a year accompanying the singer Abby Lincoln, recorded both John Coltrane and much later the saxophonist Joshua Redman. He led a successful series of small groups, including a trio and a quartet, Billy Higgins. Yet he's probably remained best known for his early work with the most influential jazz incarnations of the Jazz Messengers, with Art Blakey, yada yada. Man, that's cool, man. He's played with a lot of just super duper cats. And this says this was recorded February 22nd, 1972, Cobblestone Records. Hey, we'll say goodbye to old Cedar Walton. And we got, Steve's got a few that we're going to play this. We hadn't played this yet this evening. And Steve picked up, some of these are from Greensboro that you picked up, and some of them Atlanta.
Some of them are just over time I've picked up.
Oh, right. You got
share
some
a few
classics
records.
Here.
I didn't go with anything. I went some recent stuff.
Yeah.
But just wanted to share, I brought this Weather Report album.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Gone.
Woo.
Which, 78. I was first introduced to Weather Report on some CD that my wife had, and it blew me away. Jaco Pastorius, I'm drawing a blank on the rest of the members of the band, but Jaco Pastorius was the bass player and one of the best bass players ever. He actually produced or co-produced this album. It's really, really good.
What year is that,
78.
78?
Yep.
Solid, man. That's
now,
in the wheelhouse.
What brought me to CFBG 2 weeks ago,
right,
was on Monday. They always put out an email that says what some of the new releases are, and
right.
on Tuesday, and also what some of the new used records they have in. And they mentioned they had Jimmy Smith.
As, oh man!
They called it the album. They called the album the Incredible Jimmy Smith. It's really softly as a summer breeze. This is
a Blue Note.
It's a Blue Note record from '61, I think it is.
That was his actual title.
He is the Incredible Jimmy Smith.
Isn't that cool, man? I mean, wouldn't that be cool?
Kenny Burrell plays guitar.
The Incredible Mike Miller. I mean, just be able to just throw that
Donald
moniker.
Donald Bailey on drums.
No, it's solid. That's one of the Jimmy Smiths I've been
Philly
looking
Joe
for.
Jones on drums. It's so awesome.
Hey, let's take a little shot of liquor, and we'll say goodbye to old Cedar Walton, man.
Okay, for Cedar Walton.
Good jazz left us, but not totally. You know what I'm saying? Salut. We'll see you. Okay. We'll keep that right on down.
While I was there, also, I picked up for a dollar, I think. Some good old John Prine. Hmm. Now, the only John Prine I ever had before this was...
I don't have that one yet.
Was CD.
I'll trade you five records of your choosing for
was
that
a CD. It was a compilation, and it's a great compilation. It's called Prine on Prine or whatever.
Yeah.
This is Sweet Revenge, which has a number of those songs that are on that record.
Is this a best of?
Nope.
No.
No, this is a studio studio album.
I've not heard that one. I love John Prine.
The guy on bass is named Mike Leach.
Yeah?
It's another one of those records where there's a guy named Mike Leach playing on it.
Yeah.
That one is going on this evening.
Sweet Revenge, Please Don't Bury Me.
Yes.
Dear Abby. Grandpa Was a Carpenter. And so, right there, those four songs are great.
That's terrific.
Just great.
That's awesome. Hey, what are we playing
because
right
I brought,
now?
Because I brought Prine,
right?
I decided I had to bring my favorite country record of all time, which is one of those that our good friend Jill gave us 100 records.
And this oh,
is,
right.
This was one that I, when I saw it, I said I had to have it. This is The Redheaded Stranger.
Yeah, man.
Which, to me, there are a few concept albums out there. There are a few albums that are you have to listen from start to finish. What's Going On by Marvin Gaye.
Yeah.
The Beatles, Sgt. Pepper's, which really isn't a concept album. It became one.
I say the White Album all the way through.
But I'll tell you what.
The Wall all the way through.
Willie Nelson, The Redheaded Stranger.
Yeah.
I have to listen to the whole thing, and it just blows me away. It's so, so good. Pulling from my vault from my college days.
Oh, boy.
I was watching...
1930 what?
the 80s.
Yeah.
The 80s. I was watching Later with Jules Holland on... what's it called? Acadia? What's that station?
Palladia?
Palladia.
Speaking of the 80s, what did you think about Martha Quinn?
Yeah,
I was more of an Adam Curry fan.
By the way, she still looks great.
That
I saw
hair,
her on
Adam
Rachel,
Curry's hair.
Rachel the other day did a MTV Day. Rachel Ray, you know her daytime television
program?
Yeah, she did an 80s day the other day, and she had all the old VJs from the first days of MTV.
Yeah.
It was.
I don't want to see them.
No.
So anyway.
They were great.
Jules Holland happened to be the keyboard player for Squeeze.
No way.
He was the original keyboard player, and Squeeze didn't really make it big in the U.S., but they were huge in the U.K. They were called, like, the next Beatles when it came to songwriting. I mean, yeah, they fell way short, of course.
Sure.
But Difford and Tilbrook were the two guys who wrote and sang all these... like, Glenn Difford and...
No,
like,
you meant
Glenn Tilbrook. Difford and Tilbrook. That's the name. They even had a solo. They even had a solo album where they had a hit on it. It was called Difford and Tilbrook.
Steve, we listened to this album in high school thinking we were cool.
Squeeze Singles is a really cool album. I saw Squeeze in concert at the Fox Theater in Atlanta in the 80s, and it was amazing. It was great. They are great R&B, but British. Got that British feel to it, but it's some great... R&B, new wave.
Yeah, that's
there isn't a bad song.
So I want us to play this record tonight.
Yeah, we'll jam that.
I decided I had to share. I was going to hold off and maybe do it next week.
Yeah.
Because we need to talk about that in a minute. But
yeah,
this is one. This one record is the one I got in that store where the average price was $12. This one was $18.
Woo, $18, big ticket item.
Yeah.
Money, man.
Well, some people pay a lot more, but. This is one of those, I bought the Jimmy Smith album, and he's like, oh, you're buying some jazz. So I got some other jazz and New Arrivals. So I went through New Arrivals, and there was some jazz in there. I didn't really care about it, but I just happened to, I'll go to the end. So when I got to the end, the last record in that pile almost brought me to my knees. It's original pressing from 1971. This is called Nick Drake. It's a compilation. It's a U.S. compilation.
Grail alert.
Nick Drake put out three albums.
Grail alert.
After the first, he was so depressed, he managed two more albums before he died. But this came out after the second album. It's a compilation of those two albums that they put out in the U.S. to try and get people interested.
Yeah, wow.
And,
that's a big pickup. Dude.
That album came out on Record Store Day in the 180 gram version, brand new. It's a double album. This is the original, and I'm very, very pleased to have it.
That is awesome. Yeah. What a way.
This is one. If we play it tonight, we're going to play it at the end of the night because it's melancholy
to
the max.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, it's Nick Drake. So.
Oh, man.
But I'll tell you, I brought my guitar and I brought my Nick Drake collection, which is actually a book of his music, and it shows all the tunings because the one thing great about Nick Drake is he would write a song. He would take a guitar and just tune it down and then tune it to something just totally out there, and then create a song from that tuning.
That's awesome.
There are tunings you've never seen before.
That's Sonic Youth-ish.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
Hell yeah. Okay, hey, what a great way to finish up a fantastic dig of the week. Where a Nick Drake record that's...
So what are you going to feature next week?
Well, here's going to be the deal. And that's a great way to cinch that deal up, man. That's a grail right there. That's a grail pickup. Everybody in the VC knows finding a Nick Drake record like that.
Even I've got some great comments from some great
people.
It's not like
you got it for $2 or anything crazy.
No.
But... You found one. I've never seen one in a store, period.
It's in really good shape, too.
That's awesome. That's a great pickup. So, next week, here's the thing. I'm going to be going on a little vacation.
You don't go on vacation.
I'm going to go on vacation.
You never go on vacation.
I'm going to go down to Frisco.
He's going fancy vacation.
Fancy vacation.
Okay, that whole thing was supposed to be a surprise.
Yeah.
And you just ruined it.
No.
We were going to spring something on everybody.
So, I'm going down to Fripp Island next weekend, which is a fancy place for people to hang out.
Fripp Island?
Yeah, that's big. They got a gates in the front. You got to show your thing.
You got to wear socks?
I might have to show a card. I may have to bring the jacket. They'll know what's up.
Actually, you probably have to wear topsiders.
They'll say Grown Man Record Night, and they'll pull it up and be like, Grown Man Record, I'm sorry, come on through.
Probably if you wear socks, they won't let you on the island.
Yeah, well, that's true. So what we're going to do, I maybe do a little call-in next week. But I think Steve is going to guest host.
You know what? We're going to do something different, I think.
Yeah?
We might do something totally different.
It's up to...
Okay.
Well, I'm gonna get with cameraman, and we're going to talk about it. We might do something just off the wall.
Okay.
So you got to tune in to see what the hell... This train wreck...
It's going to be a crazy...
This train wreck goes down.
It's going to be a bizarro show.
It might be bizarro.
It's going to be a bizarro show.
We might shoot it upside down.
I don't know. The whole thing may be upside down.
Sideways.
Or sideways. So it'll be a different program. So be sure to tune in. I'm going to do a call-in.
Sideways.
It's a delightful movie.
Not to get a fucking Merlot!
Okay. So I tell you what. Before we go into listening to a little records here, and then we're going to come back with a So to Speak and Chip Chat with another guest. Our friend Jeff is going to sit down with us for So to Speak and Chip Chat with the most epic So to Speak we've ever had, and one of the most classic grails. This is a grail night. We got a grail record.
Oh, it's a grail soda.
It's a grail soda, and we've got a grail soda coming up. So here's what we're going to do. Before we do that, we're going to revisit one of the classic questions in Grown Man Record Night history.
What question is that?
The question you need to ask yourself as a Grown Man Record Night fan is Jerry Belson or Jerry Davis? There's one of them is a still, one of them is a video. The very last thing loaded.
Is it a still or a video?
It's a video, so stand by for that. So here's the
thing. Are you showing the Jerry Belson video?
Both of these guys were writers, producers on The Odd Couple, among other shows. They had two Jerrys on the set. Two Jerrys on the set. What are you going to do? How's everybody going to act with two Jerrys on the set? So we went around and we asked some people, Jerry Belson or Jerry Davis.
For 40 seconds.
Let's just get it going.
Last time they could play it.
Let's just get it
three
going.
Three times.
Yeah, here we go. One. Yep, here we go. What's Jerry Belson or
Jerry... Do you think Jerry Belson?
I'm not going to weigh in. Let's just see what happens. Let's see what happens.
Jerry Belson or Jerry Davis?
Davis.
Why?
Sounds like a better name.
Belson.
Why?
Because it's a B.
Jerry Davis.
Why?
I just think he's underrated.
Jerry Davis.
Why Jerry Davis?
I have no idea who those people are, and so I just picked one.
Jerry Belson, because it starts with a first.
Jerry Davis.
Why?
Because it's the second one.
Jerry Belson or Jerry Davis?
I don't know who either of those are.
Yes, you do. Pick one.
Jerry Belson or Jerry Davis? Jerry Davis?
Jerry Belson or Jerry Davis?
Jerry McBride.
Why?
Because he's my boss.
Yeah, I just got one question for you. Jerry Belson or Jerry Davis?
Jerry Davis.
Why?
I like the last name.
Okay.
Everybody, thanks for staying with us here on Grown Man Record Night. We're going to come right out of this little break that we had here. We're listening to some great John Prine, Sweet Revenge. We're going to come right into a little So to Speak. And this may be a So to Speak for the ages, folks. For the frickin' ages.
Well, we've got... Do you think this will eclipse Chip Chat?
No. Just this. No. This, both of the So to Speak and Chip Chat are both going to be epic.
I mean, Chip Chat's always been the bomb, and So to Speak right. Is kind of like it's a little cousin that tags along.
Absolutely.
But I think So to Speak might step up to that.
We've got a crazy So to Speak this evening. So we're going to start with something that Steve brought back, which I used to see a lot in my childhood here, and for some reason they've just disappeared, and we're talking about Mug Root Beer. This is what we got here is a Diet Mug Root Beer. I like the Diet. I like Diet. I got to watch it, you know what I'm saying? I got to take it easy because I can just look at a cheeseburger and gain weight, you know what I mean? We got Jeff joining us here. Jeff, thanks for joining us on the program.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
It's the first time for Jeff being on the program, and we're going to talk about Jeff's contribution here in just a little bit, but it's going to blow your freaking mind. It's a little Mid-Atlantic connection. So we're talking Mug here. Let's hold this guy up.
I'm looking forward to this cream soda.
I like the fact there's a bulldog on there.
There used to be a bulldog on there. So Steve, tell us a little bit about Mug. It's
popular in my family down in Georgia.
Right.
We can buy Mug. But you know, even in Atlanta, it took me an hour, and my family was real mad at me to find, because I had to call my sister to see where she got her Mug, because there just happened to be one Publix that sold it. The other Publix didn't sell it. Target didn't sell it, but they had...
Oh, good root beer.
But they had Mug in
diet.
All of them, but they didn't have Diet Mug, and we're Diet fans, right?
Sure,
now.
Man. You gotta take it easy.
It's a good smooth root beer.
No caffeine, so like later.
But I was very
evening,
pleased to find that they had a cream soda as well.
The cream soda, actually, I love a nice cream soda. I've never had Mug's cream soda.
I thought it was an Atlanta company or something Southern, but it's actually from California. Mm.
Oh, that's good. It's light. It's a light cream soda.
Oh, yeah, it's light.
It's not very diet cream soda.
It's not. Diet cream soda is one of my favorite drinks. But that's a lighter version, which I think I prefer. There's not too much taste of, like, anything. There's a hint of vanilla, which that's cool. It's not necessarily vanilla as much as it is, like, imagine if...
Maybe just vanilla.
You had a light... Vanilla. You had a light vanilla ice cream, right? Plain vanilla ice cream.
Yeah, I love
it. And it melted ever so gently, and you're eating the bottom little melty piece.
Dude,
of the,
that's the way
the
I eat ice
the
cream.
The part?
Yeah.
I let the ice cream sit in the bowl, and I just kind of skim the edge. It's like drinking a milkshake on your spoon.
That's what I'm talking about. That flavor.
Oh, strange.
That flavor of plain vanilla, that's what I like in a cream soda. And this hits it, and it hits it ever so subtly. So that's a mark for the Mug Diet cream soda.
I'd like to taste the regular
subtly.
Cream.
Subtly.
Oh, I love regular. The regular cream.
So Jeff also brought us this evening. This is from the... Jeff hooked us up with some... This is a local spot here. What is it? Pantry Express Fried Chicken. And they're... Man, they just have some down-home, like, smack-your-mama fried chicken. He brought us some regular fried chicken... And some like popcorn chicken.
And the tater wedges.
Oh man, it's all good, man. Solid.
And the special came with beer, which was.
Oh yeah, that's crazy.
It said special. The man said.
Special with beer.
It said beer. I said, "What would he goes? What would you like to drink?" I said, "Well, it says beer. Which beer do I get?" And he's like, "Top shelf, right."
And he went over to the cooler.
Went over to the cooler, took it out of the 2 bottles out of the 6-pack, and.
Yeah.
Rang it up, $3.99.
I've never seen a food special with beer.
That's awesome, man. That's good times,
good time.
Man. Like, you know you're in the right place when that's like an option. You're like, Coke, Diet Coke, Sprite, yeah. think I'm going to, let me get a little natural light with that. Okay, go grab two cold natural lights out of the freezer.
I mean, we're having a big Friday night. Fried chicken and beer.
Oh, man,
and
that's what you do.
Good and cigars.
Genuine,
good cigars.
Genuine Faygo raspberry blueberry.
So, yeah, like you said, this is Faygo. And, you know, I don't know.
Nothing screams convenience store like a blue raspberry.
But this may be out of you guys' wheelhouse, and it's a little out of my wheelhouse, and I don't necessarily care for it. But Faygo is famous for... Cameraman, do you know what Faygo is famous for?
Red cream?
No? Anybody?
It's like... Well, they had an orange pineapple. They had a pineapple.
They had some funky flavors.
They had... I was like... I thought it was going to be blue cream, like the big red,
like the red
version.
Cream soda.
And yeah. I get in the car, and it said raspberry blueberry. Said,
you guys are all way off from what I'm saying.
Yeah.
This is the big deal
the owner,
with Faygo.
The owner raped somebody.
No. Faygo is the official drink of the Insane Clown Posse.
Oh.
And I'm not necessarily a fan, but they take this stuff and they shake it up and they spray it on people. And for some reason, there's some strong connection with Faygo and the Insane Clown Posse and their fans, you know, the people with the hatchets that everybody said, they're a gang now.
So they got so the 5Ls, I hear, were a big, like a Jägermeister band.
Right.
And we're talking ICP is a Faygo band.
They're a Faygo band.
They're probably from the hood. That's
they have. Well, they have some. They have some Christian ties. There's some Christian Insane Clown Posse. It's a different little unique, I don't really understand that. Yeah, look at that. That's one of our old school Jägermeister, and look at the back of that. Look at the back of that. That's a 5L's Jägermeister shot glass.
That's impressive.
From back in the day, from where we were really doing it, man.
It's as big as your head.
If you don't know about the 5L's, just look it up. I'm not going to get into it. Yeah, I'm not going to get into it right now, but...
That's called fun with perspective.
Looking at the 5L's. Hey, why don't we drop that bug in? Let everybody know what we're talking about here. I mean, we got to do a little brand identification. Where's the bug?
Order the director.
There we go. There we go, right there. Right downstairs.
Oh, way over there.
Our good friend the bug. Where's the bug? There's the bug.
You know, I had
let's have a little Faygo.
I had dinner before I came, but this food from the pantry is so good. I just had
delicious raspberry and blueberry.
Okay.
Naturally and artificially flavored.
Is it delicious with two E's?
Delicious with two E's.
Delicious.
Does the ishish have a Z in it?
Hey, I tell you what do you think about it?
I think if I was
24 ounces,
8 years old.
Real fruity, like fruit punchy, carbonated.
Lived off a kivet, it would probably be good.
And your parents let you drink something like
that? It's got the old loaded with the high fructose corn syrup. Ooh. I tell you what, Jeff, while I'm drinking this Faygo, why don't you tell your, what's
Michael?
That cat's name? No, hang on. What's that cat's name? Don Fry. Tell your Don Fry story.
Glenn Fry.
Don Fry.
Not Don
Glenn
Fry.
Glenn Fry from the Eagles. Have you seen the Eagles? The History of the Eagles documentary.
I haven't. I heard it's very good.
No.
I know Sound City.
Let me tell you something.
Good.
It may
sit. Is it on Netflix?
It's on Showtime. I saw it a few weeks ago.
Is it new?
I don't know if it's new.
History of the Eagles.
History of the Eagles, part one and part two.
Chris Dim talks very highly.
It is unbelievable.
I heard that.
I mean, I was a child in the 70s. I didn't know how big the Eagles were. I didn't understand the Eagles. Just the stories behind the Eagles are unbelievable. And the footage that they have gathered for this to tell the story.
Yeah. Can I interrupt for a second?
Sure.
This Faygo
has
beaver taint written all over it. Yeah!
The natural, if you guys don't know, our friends of So To Speak, anytime you have an artificial flavoring, sometimes it just says artificial flavoring.
Especially if it's raspberry,
especially
strawberry.
If the flavor is raspberry, strawberry, it has this ingredient in it which comes from a beaver taint area.
Really?
A gland that they milk.
You know how you squeeze a dog? You squeeze a dog's
Mother
taint
Murphy's
to get that.
Greensboro.
Yeah, you know how a dog's glands get.
They
do that with a beaver. But that flavor ends up becoming these artificial berry flavors that are in a lot of things.
So does it taint too bad.
It taint too bad.
It's staying here, let me tell you that. It's not coming home.
Yeah. Okay.
But it's, the history of the Eagles, you should watch it.
Okay.
And there's two parts. Because there's the part of the rise.
Right.
Then the breakup. And then they said, well, we would never get back together until. And then hell froze over, and they came back to make millions and billions
and
of dollars.
Now their ticket prices are like $200
a ticket. They're billionaires. They're all billionaires. They're billionaires.
Yeah, I got a problem with that.
Anybody that charges $100 for a ticket, I got a problem with that.
If that.
I'm not saying I would see him in concert. I'm saying it was a good documentary.
Sure, sure. Okay.
No, but Glenn Frey is my friend in rock and roll.
If a sales rep had tickets, I might not turn that down.
Sure, of course. Give us the abbreviated...
abbreviated version. When I worked in Richmond, Virginia, we had to do a story about noise at the concert venue. The neighbors were complaining. It was an outdoor concert venue. Well, playing that night was Glenn Frey and Joe Walsh.
Oh.
We somehow procured an interview with Glenn Frey. Wow. We go up, we do our interview with Glenn Frey. Glenn Frey had a CBS show. He was going to be a detective. It aired.
Nope.
It aired one time and never came back on. I thought it was a good show.
Sure.
But we talked to him about that show.
Did you see his colostomy bag?
I did not see his colostomy bag.
Okay, go ahead.
I was this was 20 years ago. Hopefully he was healthy.
This is a colostomy bag free set. See.
That's Pac-Man.
Ms. Pac-Man.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous. But in the middle of the interview, he just goes to my reporter, like, who's your friend in rock and roll?
Right.
We were like, what?
I got so many.
He's like, I'm your friend in rock and roll. Anyone asks you the question, who's your friend in rock and roll? You go, Glenn Frey. I go, okay. Tell him the story for 20 years. He's my friend in rock and roll.
He's your friend in rock and roll.
He's my friend in rock and roll. You're my other friend in rock and roll.
Sure, absolutely.
Glenn Frey. He's a little richer than you.
So,
right there.
You brought what would be a grail of soda.
Oh, this
now,
is
you're from the Baltimore area, correct?
I'm from Baltimore. Grew up in Baltimore.
Right. So I've done research on this because you were on the program once before off camera, and you talked about this soda, and I've looked this soda up. Very hard to find any information about this soda whatsoever.
This soda,
okay.
It's Suburban Soda,
right?
Almond Smash. Suburban sodas.
Almond?
Almond. But it's not made with almonds. It's
hard red,
to describe.
It's
a red soda. I drank this soda as a kid.
Uh-huh. Was it more readily available then?
Yes. I mean, when I worked in the grocery store in high school, we'd take a six-pack home and with ice cream. And,
why do they call it smash?
I don't know.
And you said you made floats with it.
You can make floats with this.
It's like a
with
cream
ice
soda?
Cream. It may explode. That's the one thing. The two-liter bottles can explode. But this Suburban Colas was made in Maryland, in Baltimore. They had They had an orange, they had a grape, they had a gold ginger ale, they had a club soda, all of these things, and you could get them. And then they just kind of disappeared.
Wow.
And there's two grocery stores now that I know of that carry in Maryland. Mars grocery store. And if you don't, and whenever I'm in Baltimore, one of them is near where my grandmother lived, my aunt's, and you just go to the grocery store and you just walk through the soda aisle, maybe. Oh my God, there's three bottles.
Oh wow.
Three bottles come to North Carolina.
Wow, that is crazy.
My aunt's came down 2 weeks ago, brought two bottles.
That is awesome.
I have not had this in a year.
That is awesome.
I am just so happy to share it with you.
That is fantastic.
So needs to have some.
It's like I said, I did my research on it, and I'm pretty good about finding things on the old internet, you know what I mean? And the only thing I find, like, down the lineage is that now it's made by Pepsi.
Well, it's
PepsiCo, and it's, like, bottled out of New York.
The Suburban Cola people had the Pepsi bottling in Baltimore back in the day.
Right.
When you drove downtown
on
the Jones Falls Expressway, you look off to the left, You saw them, all the trucks there. They had the Suburban Cola trucks and the Pepsi trucks. They were all in the same thing. And now they say the golden ginger ale and the almond smash is what you want.
Wow.
And
well, here we go, folks. This is a grail. Cheers. So to speak.
I've talked it up so much.
Here we go.
I hope you enjoy it. I really do.
The almond smash.
I don't even know how to describe this taste. It's just different.
Oh, that is fantastic, man.
Awesome.
It reminds me of like the
it's cherry-ish.
It's like the cranberry ginger ale, but with a little
slight almond flavor.
Amaretto almost. Yeah.
But it's cherry-ish.
Be a great mixer. Oh, it'll be a great mixer.
Think about this amaretto with this.
Oh, man.
Hey,
That's fantastic.
So I hope you enjoy it. Don't get too attached to it because
let's go to Soda Speak Grab.
It might be a year before we get some more of it.
Could be a year. Oh man, Soda Speak. What a great Soda Speak. Grail of a soda. The Almond Smash from Baltimore. Mm. I've been waiting on this shit. I've been waiting on this shit forever, man.
Put a little ice cream in this.
Oh man.
Some Utz pretzels, big Utz pretzels. As a kid, I would make a glass of this, grab some pretzels, sit out on the front porch, read the Evening Sun that came, you know, 4 o'clock in the afternoon after school, and I didn't have a great childhood.
That's awesome, man.
It's some daggone good soda. Awesome.
Hey, let's talk about, speaking of Baltimore, let's keep it moving with that little Baltimore flavor as we sliver on over from our Soda Speak into what we like to call a little chip chat.
Ooh, I like
chip
chips.
Chat. Absolutely.
Oh, and, I didn't know there was that song.
Oh, man. At, for our open bag special, our open bag special here for Chip Chat, we're going to keep that Baltimore flavor going. And we're talking the old Utz crab chip, a staple in my family for a long time.
Oh, these are good stuff.
And potato chips with Chesapeake Bay crab seasoning. And if you're not down with these, no, they don't taste like crab. They taste like Old Bay.
It's Old Bay.
It's Old Bay.
But the thing is, it's not real Old Bay.
No, it's not.
Because there's another chip.
It would say Old Bay.
There's another chip that you can get that has the Old Bay on it. It's up in Baltimore. But this has the Old Bay light.
Grab some of those and hold them up. Look at there.
Well, I love me some Utz.
I assume everybody knows about them. I think we featured them on here before.
This is Utz's best chip.
That's the one. That's up there.
It's the first.
This one. You know, this I one in the Carolina.
I never had crab
barbecue.
Chips. I never had crab stuff. Ooh. Never had crab chips till I moved from Georgia to North Carolina.
But
the Carolina barbecue, the reduced fat sour cream and onion. Tip top. I can't explain it. They taste different and they're great.
So let me tell you.
The red hot ones that give my butthole trouble, those are good too.
TMI.
Yeah, but hey, we're all friends here.
The effects of chips on your butthole.
Absolutely.
Great memories. Growing up in first grade, we took a field trip to the Utz potato chip factory.
Are they from up there?
In Hanover, Pennsylvania, it's about 45 minutes north of Baltimore, right over right over the line.
Hanover,
Pennsylvania. They have Utz and Snyder's.
Really?
The Snyder's pretzels are Snyder's Hanover, the same thing. It's a little town. You go up Reisterstown Road, then you go up, I think it's Route 30, right there. And first grade we went, we saw them make potato chips.
Oh, wow.
They gave us a hot dog and potato chips for lunch. It was awesome.
That is top notch. Hey, we got a couple other chips from out of town. Steve brought these back from Hoplanta, is that correct?
That is correct.
Now, this Golden Flake brand, what's the deal with the Golden Flake brand?
Golden Flake, we don't see it up here.
I
thought it was a Georgia company. It's actually out of Birmingham, Alabama.
Birmingham, I got family.
P-Town, the Magic City.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Home of the Tempting Temptations.
The only time I ever went to Birmingham, I saw the Georgia Bulldogs win the SEC Championship in 1983 to go on to play in the Final Four. That's the only way they could get to
Alabama.
The tournament was to win that tournament.
Birmingham Jefferson Civic Center?
Yes.
Been to the NCAA, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Well, this is the dill pickle flavor from Golden Flake.
Yeah. May I?
Please open those up and let's try these out. We've had several dill pickle flavors. It's one of my favorites. I love the dill pickle.
Strong smell.
Dill flavor. Is it more vinegar or more dill?
That's vinegary-ish.
Okay.
I like
they can go
vinegar.
Either way. They can go either way.
They're dilly. It's
a thin chip. It's a sharp chip akin to a salt and vinegar.
Yeah, it's
like salt and vinegar mixed with a little dill.
Did you show these already?
Yeah. Much more salt and vinegar than dill. It's like a dill aftercare.
But it's good because too much dill would just destroy it.
It's true. There's some that are more.
It's got to be subtle. You can't just in your face with people.
It's a little bit of a misnomer because that's more of a salt and vinegar chip.
Yeah.
I'll have to say. But it's very good. Very good. And it's a chip we've not featured here on the program before. Wow. Let's keep it moving with one final chip here on Chip Chat.
This looks like a healthy chip.
This is a weirdo chip.
It says organic. I don't know about this one.
The name of the brand is Late July Organic Mild Green Mojo.
Why are we having it now? It's August.
It's true. There's a story behind that.
Oh, okay.
And I got a little bit to say about the story.
I'm sorry.
This is the Mild Green Mojo flavor, which is green chilies with cheese and a hint of lime. That sounds fan-freaking-tastic, I'll be honest. It's a multi-grain snack chip.
No potatoes?
16 whole grams of per serving, of whole grains per serving. That's great. So now here's the story behind the Late July brand. And I'll just read this off before I go into my little diatribe here.
Oh, goodness gracious.
In our home, everyone loves chili, so okay, this is about the chip. Let me just read, I'll read this first. So none of us could resist these Mild Green Mojo chips, the lime and creamy cheese mellow with the spiciness of the green chilies and jalapenos. It's making me salivate. Creates a mild but flavorful blend that even my youngest loves. That sounds great. It's got
youngest
some
loves.
Good healthy. So here's the thing of the summertime and the Late July brand. 10% of the profits from the sale of these chips will go to the American Camp Association.
Camp?
Camp. To provide summer camp scholarships for kids in need. We wish every child could have a chance to explore in the woods, swim in the ocean, sit by a campfire under a starlit sky, and other reasons we named our company Late July.
We should have a campfire song when playing.
Hey, you know what? I think we can give cancer a break for a little while. Let's make sure everybody can go to camp.
Send a kid to camp.
They have their priorities out of whack. I think the idea of as a kid, I was terrified. My parents would use camp as like a way to threaten me. We'll send you to camp. And I'm like, what are you doing? But camp. They're going to send kids to camp.
I don't know. I disagree.
What do you
with
think
you.
Would happen at camp?
Never mind camp.
I think camp could be a wonderful thing for
people,
a kid.
Kids.
How about a kid with cancer? Send him to
let's
camp.
See if they're decent chips or not.
But I mean, really.
They're fruit.
Heart disease.
It says organic. I'm not going to like it.
Heart disease.
Folks, they're going to die anyway.
Colon cancer.
I mean, they're gluten free. They're peanut free. What are they made of?
Listen, it said, look what they're made of.
Gluten free.
I counted it.
No synthetic pesticides or chemicals.
The word organic
is
listed in the
ingredients. No trans facts. No artificial flavors. No colors. No fructose.
They're good. But they're light and soft.
Organic ground whole corn. It's not even a potato chip.
I would not read the whole thing. It's 36 times organic.
They say, how many times do they say
36.
Organic?
36. Really? I just counted.
That's crazy. Let's try these out.
It has no flavor.
They're a little light on flavor, but they're good in a like light and subtle way.
But do you own stock in this company?
No.
They have no flavor.
I would recommend this chip.
If you didn't like flavor.
They're nice and thick, you understand? So instead of going with a standard corn chip with your dip, maybe your salsa or your queso, instead of going with plain, go with these.
Chip.
It's just light. You don't have to use like a Dorito, which is like flavor. You dip it, even more flavor. These are kind of subtle flavors.
Oh, they have late kick. It's a little late kick in there.
Yeah. I'll give it to them. They got their own.
If I want to eat chips, I want unhealthy chips.
Sure. They got their own little thing going. See, I mix these in during the week with my salads and whatnot.
Mixing in a salad now?
Sure. So for the weekend, I can eat, I can drink beer and.
That's the unhealthy chips now.
Which one you want?
Oh, either one.
Good tip.
Okay, so we've had a great chip chat this evening.
It was a good chip chat.
That's a great chip chat. We want to thank Jeff for coming over this evening and bringing.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, it's fantastic. Jeff brought chicken.
I learned so much here.
He brought the almond soda. We had some crab
cigars?
Chips.
What about cigars?
Cigars. It's been crazy. It's been a crazy evening, but a great time.
Have fun on your vacation.
Yeah, I'm going to have a good time, and I'm going to call in, and we're going to do big things here on Grown Man Record Night as we conclude this episode of Chip Chat. And what we're going to do is we're going to continue to play some rock and roll music, some of the records we talked about this evening that we have not played. We're going to continue to do that, get into some weird areas as we get later on, play some weirder stuff. So we appreciate everybody joining us. And we hope you join us next time here on Grown Man Record Night. And we'll see you soon. Be sure to check out our YouTube channel, youtube.com/MacheteMiller. And we sure do appreciate you. I'll tell you what. We appreciate you. And we'll see you next time here on Grown Man Record Night. Thanks, everybody. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
See ya.